Good morning. I'm Terrill Welch with the Terrill Welch Gallery, and I'm here this morning to talk with you about rolling with the West Coast blues. And we're going to spend some time with this 36 by 72 inch painting. Which is quite obvious what the subject is about. And it's the only painting in the ones that I have available that comes with a seasick warning. One of my collectors who has 8 of my oil paintings, including some larger ones, she's used to my style of painting and my brush strokes. And she asked if she could host this large painting on her wall. And that's something I do for collectors and others, rather than having the large paintings bouncing around in my studio. So she was really excited. I took the painting over. We got it all set up on the wall. She thought it was just great. And 6 weeks later, I get a phone call. And she says, Terrill, you have to come pick up this painting. And I said, well, how come? She says, well, you know, I get up in the morning and I'm, you know, kind of groggy and everything. And I come into the living room and she says, I get woozy and I get seasick looking at this painting. And I've started avoiding my living room first thing in the morning. And she says, we just can't have that. So I collected the painting and took it over to another collector's place and let her know what the previous person had said. And she says, no, she says, we'll be fine. And then a few weeks later, she was laughing and she says, you know, that other person is correct. She says, I prepare myself to go into the room to make sure that I've got my balance as I'm moving along looking at this painting. And so at that point, I decided it better come with a warning. One of the things about this work is a woman who has sailed with her partner several times around the world. She says, this is the ocean. And so with those things, you sort of know you've kind of got it. You kind of got it captured. But each day is completely different. This was in like March 3rd, 2013. And it had been stormy, but it wasn't particularly cold on this day. And there's a northwesterly wind slamming up against Oyster Bay, which is a place on Main Island. But there's only certain conditions that happen maybe once or twice a year where you get this inky black sea with the beautiful blues. There's 5 different blue pigments that were used to create this painting. And one of the things, if you're going to paint the southwest coast of British Columbia, you need to understand your blues. We're heavy into blues and grays. And blue, often here, when you see blue, you think sunshine. That's just the nature of our climate. And it's often the cooler shades, not the really warm shades that you'll find in California or southern France, and not the red violets that you find on Prince Edward Island. So there's a very distinctive kind of palette. For this painting, I actually have 5 videos of its process that I did, and it'll take you right from when I was taking the reference images right to the study that I did within 3 days, and then to doing the underpainting for this. And so from March, I think it was March 6th, I did the study, or even earlier, it was probably finished by then. And then it was August before I started working on this large canvas. And then it was January, I think, before of the next year before I actually felt that I was prepared to release this painting for sale. So, and some of that was when I was actually finished doing the painting, I wasn't sure I liked it. And it, so it took me that long to come to terms with what was on the canvas and be confident that it was what I wanted. This whole painting is done with large brush strokes, and as you can see, an incredible amount of movement. I have a new work that was done plein air of the same bay, just looking another 60 degrees to the left, and I want to share that with you this morning. Just to give you an idea about this one was done early August, I think. The difference in the how the sea and the sky and just the tones change from one time to another. And that's the magic for me in painting landscapes, is that even while you're painting, within, you know, that hour and a half, everything changes, and from one day to the next. Last winter I did a study of exactly the same place in the morning, in the midday, and then in the evening. And it was just, it was a, you know, it was that testament to how things change. And I think that we can acknowledge Monet for his studies of the haystacks and the cathedrals, in helping us to understand that you know, that the light changes the forms significantly, of and particularly what you pay attention to as a viewer from one time to the next. One of the questions I got recently was, did I spend much time out on the ocean, or did I mostly observe it from shore? And I says, well, other than ferry rides, I mostly observe it from shore. But as of this last few days, that's no longer true. I went on a 28 kilometer overnight kayaking trip as a birthday gift from my daughter, who's very experienced sea kayaker, and we had a marvelous time. So now the waves were not this big and not this rough, because I'm not even sure the ferries were running on this day. But we did have some really good rolling waves and being on the water. And I loved it, absolutely loved it. And I will probably do more of that. So I'll be interested to see over if I get, you know, an opportunity to spend more time actually out on the water, if that affects how I approach painting a seascape like this. So I think that that's about it. I would like to leave you with a question. What signifies sunshine and light to you? And it would be great. You could put an answer in the comments if you choose, or you could send me a private message. And I will also put the link in the comments for the blog post that talks about the whole process of this painting. So thank you very much, and have an awesome Friday, and we will talk to you next Friday, and take good care. Bye-bye for now.